when that road is completed with a good pavement, with walkways and lights, and hopefully there is also some greening along it, there will be a huge difference in that sector of town. I can only request that as a city, we should also be able to tap from the investment that we are doing. So we should be thinking about how we are going to recoup from the investment that we are making along that road and elsewhere. The children's park, when completed, should be able to help to nurture skills over here. Why wouldn't we have Olympic medalists in swimming and such other things? Because we have got the facilities where the children can start utilizing them when they are still young. So there should be deliberate programs. We should not stop at having the facilities and that's it. But I would expect that the relevant technical people in the city center, in the city council, should already be developing programs that can be helped deliberately to develop skills, for example, using some of these facilities that we're putting in place. We must develop and also grow the culture of maintenance of our facilities. I think Kat touched on the fact that these roads are called use media roads, which is okay. But you see, if that will make people think that USMID will come back and maintain them, then it will become a problem. So we would like to implore that the culture of ensuring that these are looked after very well, these facilities, the culture of maintenance is developed in this place where we are putting facilities, that they will be looked after very well and will not come back after 2 years and wonder how this could have been a USMID road when it looks so funny. Would like to employ you to make Lira City really the city that it is supposed to be. I needed to also respond, Coral Minister, to an issue or two. I know that the issues that have been brought up here are really for you. However, I would like to request you to permit me to respond on one or two. One is on planning. On physical planning, I think there was a request that we need to do physical planning and things. I think a city now is wind. I think when we are looking at local governments and when we get to a city, that child has been wind. And when a child is wind, you expect that this child should be able to do a lot of stuff on their own. They can chew food and swallow it and process it in their stomachs. They no longer need to be given soft food. Commissioner Urban Development is looking at some funding for cities, including development of master plans. However, my thinking is that also the resources that come as capacity building grants, which can be of course used for some of these things, might be adequate. We do not want to wait for too long before we have master plans which cover the entire city as it is currently. There is also the linking with other MDAs. That's the last one I want to comment about. We have been requested to link you with other MDAs, especially UNRWA and Ministry of Works and Transport, I think. Who, by the way, the Ministry of Land, Housing and Urban Development did advocate seriously for any roadworks that are going through or by a town, not even just on the cities, to make sure that they do some roads in that city or that town. That we already did. So now the onus is on the city, because you know better here what is happening, which road is coming to be worked on and things. We should already start. I think if you require the ministry's support, let us know. It should be specific support, but the initiative needs to already be taken here to contact the entities, the institution, the MDAs which are doing these works. You certainly qualify for a number of kilometers of those national projects which are done through the city. However, should you require, of course, specific support from the ministry, let us know. So with those few words, Honorable Minister, and all our friends here present, I'd like to thank you very much for God and my country.
Thank you so much, Commissioner, Ministry of Lands, Housing and Urban Development.